हेलो माय डियर क्यूरियस एंड स्टूडियस स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ सर्जरी, माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर महेश चौधरी, आई एम वार्म वेलकमिंग यू इन माय सर्जरी लेक्चर सीरीज। दिस सर्जरी लेक्चर सीरीज कंटेन्स एंटायर सर्जरी विथ एनेस्थेसिया, विथ रेडियोलॉजी, विथ ऑर्थोपेडिक, सो स्टे ट्यून विथ अस। लेट्स स्टार्ट आवर सर्जरी लेक्चर सीरीज। वेलकम डियर स्टूडेंट्स इन माय सर्जरी लेक्चर नंबर 83, दैट इज द मिसलिनियस स्किन लीजन्स। इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल सी द कॉर्न, वार्ट्स, हाइपरट्रॉफिक स्कार, किलॉइड एंड सोलर केराटोसिस। नाउ फर्स्ट लीजन ऑफ द स्किन इज द कॉर्न। इट इज लोकलाइज्ड हाइपर केराटोसिस ऑफ द स्किन। इट इज यूजुअली ऑकर्स एट द साइट ऑफ द प्रेशर, दैट इज ऑन द सोल एंड द टोज। देयर इज यूजुअली अ हॉर्नी इंड्यूरेशन ऑफ द क्यूटिकल विद अ हार्ड सेंटर। कॉर्न मे बी पेनफुल पर्टिकुलरली व्हेन इट इज रब्ड। कॉर्न हैज अ टेंडेंसी टू रिकर आफ्टर एक्सीजन। अ कॉर्न हैज अ डीप सेंट्रल कोर व्हिच रीचेस द डीपर लेयर ऑफ द डर्मिस। नाउ द ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ द कॉर्न इज सम प्रिवेंटिव मेजर्स मे बी टेकन सच एज यूजिंग सॉफ्ट शूज और सॉफ्ट पैड्स ऑफ एट द प्रेशर पॉइंट्स ऑफ द सोल। सेकंड इज द सैलिसिलिक एसिड इज द कोलॉइड और सक्सेसिव नाइट्स मे बी अप्लाइड। थर्ड इज द सेंट्रल लोकलाइजेशन लोकल एप्लीकेशन हैव बीन इफेक्टिव सच एज द कॉर्नेक एंड कॉर्न कैप इज अवेलेबल इन द मार्केट। इफ दिस मेजर्स फेल्स द कॉर्न इज पेनफुल, इट शुड बी एक्साइज विद द पर्टिकुलर केयर शुड बी टेकन एट ऑफ द डीप रूट ऑफ द सेंट्रल कोर ऑफ द कॉर्न। दिस ऑफन प्रिवेंट द रिकरेंस। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हियर इज द इमेज ऑफ द कॉर्न ऑन योर स्क्रीन। सेकंड इमेज द बिग कॉर्न्स विच इज पेनफुल। नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज द वॉट। वॉट्स आर द पैचेस ऑफ हाइपर केराटोटिक ओवरग्रोन स्किन। Such overgrowth of skin is oftenly stimulated by the virus. Warts may occur at any age but are most common in children, adolescents and young adults. Once warts appear, they may persist for many years and regress spontaneously. Sometimes family history may be obtained. Three types of the warts may be seen, that is the common warts which have been described as above: sessile warts, venereal warts and papilloma acuminata. Venereal warts are often seen in the coronal sulcus of the penis, in the anal region, scrotum and in the perineum. Venereal warts are treated by fulguration with diathermy or by the podophyllin, that is a 10 to 20% solution with tincture benzoin is used. Dear students, here is a clear picture of the warts of the skin. You can see warts on the upper and lower lips. Now the hypertrophic scar. In this condition, both the intensity and duration of the active phase of the scar formation are increased. This is characterized by hypertrophy or proliferation of mature fibroblasts or fibrous tissue without any proliferation of the blood vessels. A scar may undergo hypertrophy which remains localized and after a time slowly regresses. Characteristics of this hypertrophic scar are: it is common in young individuals. Scars crossing the natural skin series, that is the Langer's line, are more vulnerable to produce the hypertrophic scar. Infection or excessive lesions may produce hypertrophic scar. Such hypertrophic scar is limited to the scar, does not enlarge the surrounding normal skin. These are usually no claw like processes. There is no itching, there is no sign of increased vascularity, and hypertrophic scar is never reddish in the color. It is gradually regresses after 6 months. It does not recur after excision if the causative factors are eliminated. Dear students, here is the image of the hypertrophic scar on your screen. Another image of the hypertrophic scar. Now the next entity of the lecture is the keloid. The main distinguishing features between a keloid and a hypertrophic scar is that the keloid is normal surrounding tissue is affected by the spread. The hypertrophic scar is never gets worse after 6 months, but a true keloid continues to get worse even after a year. It is characterized by the proliferation of the immature fibroblasts and also immature blood vessels. A keloid has claw-like processes. It looks smooth, pink and red patch. A keloid is incisively, often tender to touch and always itch. The most characteristic features of keloid is that it recurs even after it is excised. Etiology: there is a few etiology factors which has been caused for the keloid, that is, and these are: the colored races are particularly liable to the keloid formation. Negroes are commonly affected. It is a familiar condition. It is a more common in women. Dear students, here is the image of your skin. Is a typical keloid. This is the keloid in the Negroes, keloid on the chest. Now the fourth etiology is that tuberculosis plays a more role in etiology. Patients with tuberculosis often suffer from the keloid formation. Local factors, that is, if the infection incision crosses of the Langer's line, keloid formation is more common. Discoloration of the hair follicles is also a factor which is more often seen in the burns. Now the treatment of the keloid is extremely difficult. Conservative treatment is intracheloidal injection of the steroids is helpful and should be considered as the best treatment. Injection keratinocon
spot seems to be the quite good in this regard. Intracheloidal hyaluronidase injection may be tried. Intracheloidal injection of the vitamin A has been given some better result. Intracheloidal injection of the methotrexate has been used with some success. Deep X-ray therapy has also debatable success. It suppresses further proliferation of the immature fibroblasts and blood vessels, so it may stop further growth of the keloid and stop itching. Next is the ultrasonic therapy has been recently been tried up to some success. And surgery, excision and re-stitching is oftenly followed by recurrence, shaving away the excess scar tissue and even resurfacing of the area by the thin skin graft, though advocated by a few surgeons. Now the next point is the solar keratosis, that is the senile keratosis. Prolonged exposure to sunlight will cause hyperkeratosis of the skin, which is known as the solar keratosis. This condition oftenly takes malignant changes. There are usually seen on the face, backs and on the hands. Patients are usually above middle age. These are usually work out of the doors from many years. Patient notices appears of thickened patchy skin. Dear students, here is the image of the solar keratosis. Second image, solar keratosis on the nose. Examination of the solar keratosis, that is the thickened patch, are yellowish gray or sometimes brown in color. Usually the lesions are less than 1 cm in diameter. They have a dry hard scale on the surface of the lesion. It is a hard lesion which is firmly adherent to the skin. Carefully watch must be kept to note that this lesion is undergoing malignant changes or not. Lymph nodes are never palpable in solar keratosis. If renal lymph nodes are palpable, it is sure that the lesion has turned malignant. Dear students, here is the end of our surgery lecture number 83, that is the miscellaneous skin lesions. Thank you.